My name is Indrajeet Sharma, and I am an assistant professor at the Department of Chemistry, University of Oklahoma. We are a synthetic chemistry group interested in the development of creative new ways to make drug molecules. As the cost of a drug is directly related to the number of synthetic steps involved, the goal of our research has been the development of catalytic convergent reactions that provide high atom economy and generates minimal waste in the process. Every now and then, I'm asked, what disease area do we work on? And my mentality is, why limit yourself to one? Our diazo cascade chemistry is so powerful that we can potentially cure anything.
Target classes in the Sharma research team include compounds which are relevant in drug discovery but have been unexploited due to challenges associated with their synthesis. Spirocycles are one of such classes of molecules, which are found in a wide range of bioactive natural products and drug structures.
Despite interesting biological activities, these molecules are represented in less than 0.1% of NIH screening collections. The reason being is the stereoselective installation of quaternary spirocenters.
To address this synthetic challenge, we imagine the use of ambiphilic diazo synthons, which offer dual reactivity with both a nucleophilic and electrophilic center, and thus are ideal for the construction of quaternary spirocenters. Diazo chemistry has been underutilized in the field, though, potentially due to the negative stigma associated with the stability of diazo compounds. This high-risk, high-reward approach is unique, as we are trying to build on an unexploited chemistry for underrepresented structures.
Currently, I'm working on diazo methodology. I'm actually going to show you guys a reaction from our latest paper. So today, we're going to take this very stable diazo compound along with three alkynoic alcohol with our synergistic catalytic cocktail, and we're going to make some substituted tetrahydrofurans today. So I have our three catalysts in this vial. We have our rhodium ESP, our silver triplet, and our gold triphenylphosphine. And right here, I have a solution of our alcohol in dichloromethane. And so I'm just going to take it out and add it in here. And so you'll see that's kind of fizzing up. And we're just going to go sonicate it for a couple seconds just to make sure everything's soluble. This is a really robust reaction. We don't have to add our catalyst in the glove box or anything, which is really, really nice. So now if we observe the color, we see that it's this nice light blue till color. But once we add our diazo, we're going to see something really cool happen. So we're just going to let this get to stirring. And our diazo is a nice yellow solution. And so we don't have to add this via syringe or anything. And you see those bubbles forming? That's the nitrogen coming out. And so this is an instantaneous reaction. And we see that there's actually a color change happening. So that nice, pretty blue color is actually turning pretty nasty. And so if we were to spot this on a TLC, we'd actually see our compound form pretty instantaneously. We actually did some NMR studies that proved it. And that's diazo chemistry for you.
There is widely held myths that diazos and azines are all unsafe to work with due to their inherent instability and explosive capacity. But our diazo compounds are adjacent to a carbonyl group or an electron withdrawing group, which vastly increases the stability of the compound, rendering it bench stable at room temperature.
We envision diazo cascade reactions as one of the rare opportunities to provide a paradigm shift in how spirocycles are made. The cascade reactions use readily available inexpensive chemicals, generate minimal waste, and will ultimately reduce the cost in developing therapeutics. This chemistry will also have a broad impact across all areas of society, including chemical synthesis, medicinal chemistry, and drug discovery.